Hello, this is Pamela. Welcome to my channel. Grab you a cup of coffee, sit back and relax, and enjoy some yarny goodness.
Hello everyone, this is Pamela, and you are on Pamela's Adoring Crochet. Welcome to my channel, and if you are new to my channel, I would like to say hello, and my channel is mostly all about crochet, so if you like to crochet, I hope you enjoy this channel. I'd like to say thank you to all my subscribers, and I am close to the 2K, so I will be having a 2K giveaway. So be sure and look out for that video. I'd like to show you what I have done today. I have two finished objects. I have one that I'm going, well, two that I'm going to start, and I have two like little giveaway wins that I got in the mail today. And so I'd like to share that with you guys if you guys are interested. So the first thing I would like to show is this is a poncho that I found off Bag O' Day. Crystal designed this. And I'm sure you saw some of the pictures. But here it is. Very easy. Honestly, I'd have to go back and look at my on my Facebook group page. If you are not have not joined my Facebook group page, please do. I love it, and so do all the people that are on that page. We like when you guys post the things that you're making or that you're working on, or even if you got questions about certain things that you're not sure of, or you'd like advice on colors or how to do certain stuff. You know, and it's a lot of fun, and we all support each other. So, but where I had saw this was, and I'm not sure exactly which person on my Facebook, because I'd have to go back and look, but it was either Elaine or it was Cynthia. So I can't remember. They're both in the same, we're all in the same group, not same group, but the same message talking about the same poncho. So I can't remember exactly who it originated from, but I'm thinking maybe it was Cynthia. So anyway, ladies, you both get credit. So I'm sorry if I'm not sure exactly which one started, but hey, we're all in this group together, right? But anyway, so we're talking about the Bag O' Day, and so one of the ladies had made this first, and they're like, we were all like, oh, we like that. So I made this. Now, I used, I was planning on making this for my daughter, like for a little cover up when she goes to the pool or something, or, you know, getting ready to leave or whatever. She could have her little swimsuit top on and a pair of jean shorts, you know, something cute. And then, you know, just put this over her. But, so I'm thinking after it's done, I'm like, well, I don't know, you know, if she don't want that, I definitely want to keep it because this thing feels good. Now, Bag O' Day did one in the shawl and a ball, and I do plan on doing one in the shawl and ball. Matter of fact, I've already got it sitting on my coffee table in my living room waiting to do next, because I do want the shawl and a ball. But I did this with cotton yarn, and I did it because in case my daughter was going to wear it to the pool, I wanted it to be able to, you know, absorb the water and stuff a lot better than the acrylic yarn would do. So that being said, here's what I used. I used this Sinfonia, and I've used two of these in this color. And guys, I have looked everywhere and I can't seem to find the sleeve that went on it. I saved them, you know, to show you guys in the video, and for the life of me, I cannot find it. I have gone through all my stuff. I have taken this project over to my mom's house and my dad's and worked on it over there. So I don't know if maybe it slipped out of my bag or something somewhere. Maybe I laid it down. I don't know, but it's not where, and I'm really good at keeping up with my sleeves. So somehow I have misplaced that. But I do still have the one for the white, and I can tell you a little bit about it. It says it's 100% mercerized cotton. And it's 3.52 ounces. It's 218 yards. So for this turquoise color, which it's a real, you know, nice bright. This is what I have left. It's a really good color. And I used two. Now, the reason I have some left over is only because it didn't quite make it all the way around. And so I just frogged back what was left and then added the white. I probably could have stopped with that turquoise. Nah, I did need to go on. Now let's see it in the camera. Yeah. So, and then what I did on the end, I just did single crochet just to give it a little weight and hold it down. I wasn't really sure what I wanted to do, but I was just kind of tired of working on it. I was wanting to hurry up and get it done, so I just did the single crochet. And if you guys have made this, I don't know, maybe if I'm a slow crocheter, but this seemed like it took me forever. But of course, I did have to take it places with me, so that could have something to do with it, you know. I wasn't able to just sit down and work on it. It was work it here, a little bit work it there. So that could have something to do with it. But I am really proud of this. This is my first poncho type thing like this. Anyway, so I will leave the bag all day. It's called the Lacy Mint Poncho. And I will leave the link below so you guys can go check it out. And like I said, she does hers in a shawl and a ball. And it's really pretty. And I do plan on doing that next. Matter of fact, the pattern is such a easy, it's a repeat of row, let's see, repeat row two, I believe. All the way through, yeah. Because I say on row three, repeat row two. So yeah, it's so short of a pattern, guys. I have it written on this little notebook paper right here. So yeah, go check it out. She used one ball, I think, which was 418 yards. So there you go. And it does take a K hook. K is a 6.5. I don't know if you guys can read this on there or not because it's so tiny. But this is the only K hook I have. So, and I do like it. It worked really good. I like this hook. But it's the only one I have. So I don't have it in the clover. You know, most of all my hooks that I use is the clover soft hook. But somehow I have this in my inventory and I really like it. I don't know what brand it is, where it come from. Let's see, it does say Japan. Oh, here we go. I can barely read it, but it is on there. Hold on, guys. It says clover on it. Huh. Yep, it says clover. I really like that hook. I'm gonna have to look that up on Amazon and check that out, see if I can find something like that. I had no idea, but I don't know where I got it, but it's with my hooks and it's so easy to find because it's the bright green. Okay, so there we go. There's that. And my other finished object is, I don't know if you guys know that I have a pattern business for the 18-inch doll clothes and it's for the 14.5-inch and it's, I'm designing crochet patterns for those dolls. Well, if you like subscribe to my email, that's not right. If you're an email subscriber to my newsletter, then every month I send out a free pattern and it's usually like an accessory, you know, a little poncho, a hat, you know, so it's just something cute to go with your stuff, but they're free patterns and I have to design them and sometimes it takes me an entire day just to do that one little pattern. Sometimes more than that, depending on I can't get it to work right. So anyway, so if you're an email subscriber on adoringdollclothes.com, then you get a free pattern every month along with a coupon, 10% coupon every time I release a pattern. Well, for the month of July, this is a roll-up beach towel and a little beach bag. Isn't it cute? I just love this kind of stuff. And it's got a little flat bottom. What is funny about this one, I guess I can go ahead and tell you guys because, you know, I know you guys will probably just laugh with me and have fun. This was supposed to be a pail, you know, for the beach. And it was supposed to be small here and go out rounded. And then I was going to take a silver yarn and make a whatever, the handle. Well, as it was going forward and doing its job and stuff, it just didn't come out right. So I was like, I turned this into a beach bag, guys. Look at that. Okay, and then the little beach towel. What I did with this is I put a little button on, and then I put this little single crochet with a hook right here. I mean, with a hook, with a loop on it. So there you go. And the towel can just roll it out. See? And I did different, I don't know if it looks like it on there, but it does have different stitching on it. It's not, it is all single crochet, but I did the stitching different per color. I don't know how to explain that, because I don't want to tell you exactly how I did it, because then it won't be a free pattern on my, and then I won't get you as an email subscriber. And I need all my email subscribers. So anyway, so that's my finished object. I hope you guys like that, and go and subscribe to my blog. So let's move that out of the way. So that is this, and this is my finished object. Okay, moving on. The other thing is, I did go to the Dollar Tree. Linda from Linda's Yarn Barn, she's from Oklahoma and I'm from Arkansas, and we met up about 2 to 2.5 hours in the middle, and we had some catfish and we exchanged some yarn and things like that. Well, in one of hers, she had given me this right here, because she knows I'm just learning how to do graphkins, and I'm really excited about that. And anyway, Terry from Yarn Joy Podcast just got through, I don't know if she's finished, I can't remember now, but anyway, she's working on a llama bag, and it is so cute. Well, Linda is working on it as well, and so Linda told me to just go to the Dollar Tree, grab me another pack, because I'll need two of them. And so here's, like, the graphkin of it, and I guess I gotta, like, put those together, tape them together or something. But anyway, Linda just finished it, and it's her first one, and oh my gosh, it is lovely. Linda, you did a great job. So I do have that on my list. So now I have two packs of these, thanks to Linda. Oh, and then when I was at the Dollar Tree, my daughter takes me up there, and I'm like, I just got to get one thing, and then after I get that one thing, then we can shop. So we go in, and it's so hard when you're in the Dollar Tree not to stop at all the cute things all the way to the back of the store. And I'm like, Linda told me it's where the clothespins are, and that's in the back of the store. So I'm like really trying not to stop. And I get back there, and I see the clothespins. I don't see any of this. And I'm like, oh my gosh. You know, we don't have another Dollar Tree around here. And that Dollar Tree's not like in my town, right? It's in the next town. So the next Dollar Tree would be in another town. And so I'm like, oh man, I was, you know, just kind of heartbroken. Well, I happened to happened to look down at the bottom and look, searching around there to see if somebody may have laid it down. And sure enough, somebody laid one down. That's it. I did look around to see if there might be some more, but there weren't. There was just one. So that was all I needed, though. She said I would need two packs of them, and so that's what I did. I got that. Okay. The other thing is, I found this, and I don't know. This is shawl in a cake. I've used a shawl and a ball, and I'm assuming they're probably the same thing. I don't know. But it's shawl in a cake. It doesn't seem to be, I don't know, it might be the same. Didn't seem quite as twisty. But anyway, it's sparkly. Look at that. Isn't that pretty? It kind of reminds me of like canyon colors or something. I don't know. But it's shawl in a cake, and it's called Moonstone. And I, for the life of me, you guys, I don't know where I got it. I don't know if I won this in a giveaway someone gave me. I don't remember. But I found it in one of these drawers down here. And so I decided I'm going to make me another shawl. You know, have y'all seen the shawl that I did a tutorial on? If you haven't, go check it out. I'll leave the link below. So I'm gonna make me another one, and it's gonna be in this color right here. So yeah, and then the one that I'm making, the poncho that I'm gonna make, is going to be in the other shawl in a ball that I won from Nanny's Crochet Corner. And Jeannie is her name. Hey, Jeannie. So I'm gonna use that other skein or other ball of yarn that I won from her and make me one of these. So I'll end up having a poncho and a shawl in the same colorway. but I really like that colorway. So, okay. So that's one of the things that's on my list. And I will show you what I got in the mail today. Christy from Crochet Creations by Christy. She has this... she has a lot of stuff. My goodness, guys. I'm going to leave her Facebook link below. Go check her out because she has so many giveaways and it is so much fun. I did win this one. This one was for the, if you post your progress of the Clement Poncho, post it on there and then she spins this wheel and on this certain one, she does them all different, but on this certain one, she spun a wheel and it was the last man standing. And I thought, oh man, that's so cool. So I watched the whole thing. Of course, it happened to be me that won it, but I watched the whole thing just because I'd never seen anything like that. And she would, when she gets someone's name, she would knock them off, remove them, and then whoever's last standing. And I was last standing. So just for entering my, posting my picture, I won this. Look at that. Isn't it pretty? I'm so excited about this. It is so soft. Actually, I had just bought, and it's in the loom room, I had just recently bought me some willow yarn. I haven't got to try it out yet, but it's a DK. And this one right here says that it is, let's see, it's 206 yards, made in Turkey, 50% superwash wool, 50% acrylic. Fuchsia is the color. And I thought it said something, well, I thought it said something about, you know, whether it was like sport weight, four weight, or whatever. I can't remember, but I don't see that on here. Anyway, it is really pretty. See, look at that. So I was really excited about that. So anyway, Christy, on her Facebook group page, she has all types of entries like that. She just had one in June where, oh my gosh, the entire month of June, all you had to do was anything that you made, no matter what it is, I did a cross stitch, I posted it. This will go on her, I think, I'm sure she'll have a July. I haven't looked yet, but I'm gonna put this on there for July. And my yellow Addy cardigan will go for July. But she has a real nice prize that she gives for that. And for the whole month, everybody, no matter what you make, you know, just post it, post a picture, and then she has a drawing, and then somebody wins. so anyway, I think that's exciting. And you get to see literally what everybody is working on, and it's a lot of fun. So thank you, Christy, for doing that. I really appreciate that, and I'm sure everybody else does. It's a lot of fun. But she has other things too, other giveaways like that. Hat thing, you know, when you post your hats, that has a monthly giveaway for that. She has a weekly giveaway. I haven't won that one yet. You know, I will someday. You can just bet. Who knows? It could be 5 years from now, but hey. You know, I'm optimistic. So, but anyway, yeah, go check out Christy's page. She has a YouTube channel and I will leave it in there. She is so good. She makes a lot of baby items and stuff. I'll leave her channel below so you can go check her out. She's a sweetheart. Okay, so we have that. Now, oh yes, the other thing is the giveaway that I won. This was from Crystal from Chronically Crocheting. And this was really cool. Look at this organza bag that came in, guys. This was for, I put on her Facebook page, I entered a picture of, I entered two pictures. One of my pictures won, and I think it's just, you know, random. But she had two winners, and it was for the, what they call the June Stash Buster. And, I don't know how she picked the winner. I can't remember. I don't know if it was random comic pick or if it's a wheel, you know, I don't really know. But anyway, I won. I was prize number two. Linda from Linda's Yarn Barn, she was prize number one. So I got this card here, and I love this card, Crystal, by the way. And I'm gonna leave Crystal's link below, her Facebook link and her YouTube channel for Chronically Crocheting. And I'm going to do the same thing for Christy and Linda's. Anybody I mentioned in this video, Yarn Joy, any of those, I'm going to leave the links below for you guys, okay? Anyway, so there's this pretty card. Isn't that pretty? And she took her time out and wrote this real nice little card here for me. I mean, that was so sweet to just take your time out to do that. Thank you so much. And she made this, guys. Look at that. She made this with her own hands. She made this. And let's see if you can see that right there. Let's see. There you go. Isn't that pretty? So, and I love the yellow zipper. I mean, the yellow zipper makes the bag. So inside, look at, it's all pink and pretty. I mean, I'm really proud of this bag. So we got these like rainbow, they look like iridescent type scissors. Look at that. and then this here is really cool. This is a tape measure, but it's like a leather tape measure. And it's like a bright yellow. So I really like this too. I got some really cool little things in the mail today. Looky there. So anyway, that's cute. And it's like really expensive looking. You know what I mean? It just has that feel about it. So I've got that, and I'm so excited about these scissors, really, because they're small. Let me see about the weight of them. They don't feel, the package doesn't feel heavy. So I'm hoping, I was really hoping they were lightweight, because they look lightweight. So, and I really need some lightweight scissors right now. Okay, so I'm going to have to use my Fisker scissors and see if I can't open this. So here we go. Oh wow, I see that it comes with like a little case to put it in. Not a case, but I mean a little, okay, no it doesn't. That is, I thought that that was something like the scissors go in, but it's not. It's just, I guess it, I don't know what it is. It's just leather. But it's just a leather piece. I don't know what it was. Just, it was just on the back. I thought maybe, you know, you slide your scissors in it, but you don't. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Yes, you do. Look at that. I found there is an opening. Okay, yes, they are nice and lightweight. Look at that. So you carry them and held them in like that. Isn't that nice? Let's see. Look at the colors on that. So I'm really excited about that. Okay, so I'm going to have to figure out how to get that stickiness off. Maybe some alcohol will get that off. Okay. Oh, and then I thought this was kind of neat. Put my trash out here. And my Fisker's back. Okay, so not only did I get those and this nice card, but, you know, I got this organza bag that I can use to put my little small projects when I'm just running on the go. But the bag that she gave me was this, it was shipped in this purple bag. But inside the purple bag, this stuff was in another purple bag that hasn't been used before. The tab hasn't been pulled off of it. So guess what, guys? I can ship stuff in this purple bag. So I gained something. Yeah, so thank you, Crystal, for thinking of little things like that. So I got a shipping bag that I can turn around and ship someone else's gift in that I send them. And yeah, so that's really nice. Okay, hold on just a second. I want to show you what I bought at the Dollar Tree. More Dollar Tree stuff. This is, I think you guys are going to think this was a really good idea. Now, my daughter, Jennifer, she helped with this. We went in together. So, on game night, we probably have, let's see, we have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have at least 8 people on our game night. So, we bought like 10 of these at the Dollar Tree. See, all colors. Aren't they pretty? And they come with the ink pens. See? So that's what's really neat about it, is everybody, like especially when we're playing a Family Feud or something, see, everybody has their own ink pen attached right there. And, you know, they can write down their words or they're keeping their score, you know, whatever you got to do. And then they all have an ink pen. Because on game night, I'm running around the house. I'm trying to grab all my little notebooks, all my little pens on every Thursday, you know, just for everybody to have the games, play the games. And so now we have these. So we bought like 10 of them because our game night seems to be growing. yeah. It is growing. I was at Walmart and I was like, I saw these cups, and normally don't buy these kind of cups. I mean, I have so many cups, I don't need cups. Matter of fact, I'm clearing out 2 cabinets today. I'm going to clean them out before the party. And then I'm gonna run to the Dollar Tree and buy some plastic cups to put in the place of all my breakables. And I'm gonna move my breakable stuff and put them somewhere, probably out in the garage in the storage cabinet or something. And guys, the reason I'm doing that is because just me and my husband live here. And the cabinet is full of nice glassware sets, you know, that back in the day when my parents were healthy and my daughter was young and my sister's kids were young, we always had parties over at my house. And so I had to have, you know, all the glassware and all the plates and plate sets, and you know, because I always had a lot of company. Paper plates weren't popular back then like they are now. And so those are just taking up a lot of space. So I'm just gonna remove that. I'm going to the Dollar Tree and I'm gonna buy like 6 plastic cups, 6 plastic plates, and I'm not even gonna get any coffee mugs. I have a little tree that's got like 6 mugs on it. I don't have enough people over, guys. So, yeah, I am downsizing. And, but anyway, so yeah, that's what I'm gonna do this afternoon, is clean that. Okay, back to what I had bought. So I was at Walmart, and so for game night, I thought, you know, this would be a lot of fun. I bought a bunch of these, and I probably need to go back because I really need 10, but I bought some of these things just for fun. You know, everybody can sit around. Everybody at the table, it's a light bulb. And everybody will have their own cup. And we don't really have any kids. We have one, which is, she's my step-granddaughter. And so she's really the only kid, and she's like 10, I believe. So I'm trying to move some of this out of the way. So anyway, so like here's green. I mean, we got all colors here. Another light bulb. They had them for $3.48 at Walmart. And I thought, you know, this would be fun on game night. See? So, they're all clean, washed up, ready for tonight. And, yeah, we're going to have some fun. Okay, so I guess I'll put these up. And these are really too tall for the cabinet. So, I'm going to find something to keep these in. Because we will only be getting them out on Thursdays. You know, so I'm gonna find something to put them in that's not gonna take up a lot of space. Okay, so I hope you guys have enjoyed this. I have, and I'm gonna read to you. Where's my Bible? Where's the Bible scripture? Okay, here it is. this is the Words Alive. This was my Granny Ralston's, and then it was my mother's, Iva Ralston, and so now it is mine. And let's see what we got today. It says, the angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him and delivereth them. Psalms 34:7. It always looks like it blows out when I put it up there. So, you know, but at least you heard it, right? You heard the word. So that is the God's word for the day. So that is all that I have. I am working on stuff, but as far as finished stuff, that's all that I've got. And, oh yes, be sure and keep my dad in your prayers and my family. And, yeah, so if you feel like you want to like my videos, you want to share my videos, you want to leave a comment, because you know I comment on every single video that you guys leave me. And if you want to do that, that's fine with me. And if you want to tap the bell so you'll be notified that I have, every time I post a video, that'll be fine with me as well. So, and subscribe if you want to. So I appreciate each and every one of you, and I will see you in my next video. Thank you, guys. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video.